Dawn of Heroes for DC. Detective Comics, for you guys who don't know that.
Love it. I'm a Batman fan. You're a Superman fan, as we can see from the jacket. Let's go and take a look.
Have a look.
Well, superheroes are obviously connected with Greece, of course. They are connected with the ancient god of Greece, Superman himself. And I think we can say that superheroes are contemporary, mythologic, but they took lots of the Greek mythology. And I think this is interesting. And this is also the purpose of the exhibition, to show to a large audience that behind what they love, there is amazing artists, but in sociological term, it's connected to history of art, but to history. So yes, it's important to say that, and of course, Greek means a lot and brings a lot. When Joe Shuster and Jerry Siegel, the creator of Superman, and they were 17 at the time, create Superman, it's important to know that their inspiration was obviously gods of ancient Greek, and then they had the Greek mythology, Knights of the Round Table, and technology, and they created a new genre. So, of course, Wonder Woman is an Amazon, and therefore it's more and more obvious in that way. But all the superheroes have to give credit to gods of ancient Greek. Yes, of course.
What would your favorite superhero be? You have to pick one.
Maybe Batman, because I love all those guys because they mean a lot. I grow up with those characters, and they bring value. And sometimes, at the opposite, I love the villains, such as the Joker. But maybe Batman is more close from everybody because he's a human trying to be a superhero by himself. So it's interesting. Superman has been created, and the year after, Batman has been created. And they are at the extremity of all the other superheroes. Between them, there are all the other superheroes are content. So it's interesting. And the third one who has been created by DC was, of course, a woman. And was, of course, a goddess from ancient Greek. So I think it would be, for myself, Batman. But I love also. I am really touched each time I see that costume behind me. It's a Christopher Reeve costume, because I saw it on the screen, and that touched me in such an intense way. And Christopher Reeve brings a lot. He gives birth to Superman in a way on the screen. So I am really touched by that. But the Batman's room takes me.
costume, which is the first reincarnation of Wonder Woman, is this one that you'll see here. And it was created by Michael Wilkinson. And when I came to do, for Batman versus Superman. So when I came to do Wonder Woman 1, then my job was to create not that costume. We did adapt it and play around with it. But to create her life, her costumes of her environment. Which be all behind me, which is her life on the island of Themyscira, wherever that is, in from 4,000 years ago up to the time when she leaves. And so my, you know, I was using the influence of Michael Wilkinson's costume to put into my Amazon costumes so that you believed that they were the same story.
Wonder Woman's Greek origin, is it reflected in her design? Think?
Well, I did lots and lots of research, of course, as you do with all designs, and I researched a lot of ancient Greek costumes, a lot of Spartan costumes, and I found that I believed that the Wonder Woman civilization could be possibly from ancient Macedonia or Thrace. Because in Thrace there were queens and warriors who were women, and so it seemed to suit our purposes quite well. Which is Greece.
You've won an Oscar. And we'd just like to know, well, our viewers would love to know as well, where do you keep the Oscar? I know most people keep it in their downstairs loo. So where do you keep your Oscar?
It's a complicated story where my Oscar is, but it's living in Italy.
Oh, okay.
It's staying on a farm in Italy. Okay.
Guys, thank you for watching GreekBeatRadio.com's trip today. This is the Cinema Club with me, Tony Greekos, and Sim Simo. We enjoyed ourselves at the O2 Arena and we got to see the DC exhibition, Dawn of Superheroes.
Now don't forget, the exhibition is until September this year. So if you want to get down there, it's the North Greenwich Station at the O2 Arena. We want to say thank you to Jean-Jacques Laurier, we've got to speak to, curator, founder of the DC exhibition, Jenny Payson, Amazonian, in Wonder Woman, so she played in the movie and spoke to her, Lindy Hemming, costume designer, and features in the exhibition as well. Hey, don't bother, he's gone again. Hey, keeps it going. Anyway, share, like, and subscribe.